Now in parsing as deduction, parsing as deduction combines parsing from computational linguistics with the deduction from the logics. And this means we are now having a deduction system where we can put different rules into, and the deduction system will keep tracks of our items or expressions or whatever you would like to call them. And the parsing strategy is handled by the rules we put into it. So we are separating parsing strategy from the control strategy, and we can use the same system and just change the algorithm by switching the rules we put into it. So if we are, for instance, putting in to it scan and predict, we will get a top-down parsing, and if we are putting in shift and reduce, we will get a shift reduce parser. On the one hand, this can make some proofs easier, for instance soundness and completeness. So if you want to prove that everything you can derive with a logic system is in your is a word from your grammar, and if every word that's in your grammar can also be derived with those parsing algorithm, this can be easier. And also, maybe not for top-down and shift-reduce parsing, but for other algorithms, you can just, with the deduction rules, you can just count how many of the variables are depending on the length of the input string, so you can estimate the complexity sometimes more easy. And the disadvantage maybe is that if you are having you are limited in the optimizations that you can do. So for instance, if you are implementing one parsing algorithm in the classical way, then you can create dedicated data structures that can greatly help you to speed up your parsing. But in parsing as deduction, you have the overall system, and it's very limited how you can improve them. But on the other hand, you could use a parsing as deduction system if you don't know which parsing algorithm will suit your data, and you can play around with that and try out different parsing algorithms before you decide which one to use and which one you want to re-implement in a more speed-up way. Of course, if you are not much taking care of the parsing algorithm you are implementing, so if you are not putting in effort for optimization, then it also might be around the same speed as a parsing as deduction approach. So it depends on the case. Now, for parsing as deduction, we need the parsing scheme, which consists of those deduction rules. They look really much like the rules we use in logics. So we have those antecedences. You can also call them items or expressions or lines in the table. So this is something I might confuse some terms, so because you can call it a lot of different ways, but you have those antecedences. I like to call them items, so like they are like lines in the table, which you are putting into a rule to derive consequence items. And for this, in this case, we also might need some side conditions. So that means these are not other things you have in the table, but other circumstances that need to hold so that you can derive the new item, the consequence item, from your antecedents. Then you usually start out with an empty table, so you cannot apply deduction rules yet. And for that situation, you have the axioms, which you need to initially fill your table. So they are like the deduction rules without antecedents, because we have to start somehow, and at the beginning the table will be empty and you can only apply the axioms. And then we also need a goal item. That means an item that tells us if we have our whole table of items, then the goal item, if we find it somewhere in the table, it tells us that the parsing was successful or that the word is in the grammar. And if we don't find it, then, well, then not. Now, the general working of parsing as deduction. We have those charts that is like the table we have seen before in our parsers. Then we have the agenda. This one contains new items we want to try out to derive another new items, so that we are not applying the same items over and over again. So the agenda will contain only new items we haven't tried out yet. So at the beginning we are using all axioms to initially fill derive items, and we are putting all new items into the chart and into the agenda. And then we are applying rules while the agenda is not empty. We are picking one item from the agenda and removing it. Well, here can be some variety in this, so you can say you take always the oldest item from the agenda, or you take always the newest item, or you can choose which item you want to use from the agenda, but you have to pick any one item from the agenda and you remove it, so you will not use it again. Then you will use the item and apply it. Use it with deduction rules to derive new items. The rules we have seen so far take only one item, so then you would take only this one. But if some rules take several items, then you would combine this item with other items from the chart to get the right amount of items and use that to derive new items. Then, if you derive items that are not in the chart yet, you are putting them into the chart and into the agenda. So you will try them out. You will try to derive other items with them later by putting them into the agenda. And if you are deriving items which you already have, then you can also say, for instance, you are updating the chart and you are making a note saying, well, you already derived the item in one way, but you can also derive it in another way, and then just update the chart if you are deriving an item you already have. And then at the end, you are repeating the steps until the agenda is empty. And after that, you check if your chart contains the goal item. And if that is the case, then, well, the parsing was successful, the word is derived by your grammar, the deduction system will return true, however you want to put it. Or if that's not the case, if there's not a goal item, then it returns false, then the word is not in the grammar, or then the parsing was not successful.